and Shebna the secretary, and the senior priest covered with sackcloth to the prophet Isaiah the son of Amos. Verse 3. They said to him, "Thus says Hezekiah, this day is a day of distress, of rebuke, and of disgrace. Children have come to the birth, and there is no strength to bring them forth." Baby, you can call me a superman.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel.
It's your boy Jesse Keegan
and your girlfriend Anungu,
and we are Funny Jesse. So right about now we're going to do another reaction, but before we get into the reaction, guys, we want to thank everybody for subscribing to our channel. Also, we want to thank the people who have been giving us reaction to react to. You're the realest MVP, man. A lot of people, like, you guys have been so nice to us. What do you think?
Mm-hmm.
Have been so nice to us, man. Thank you so much for the guys who went and subscribed to our channel, our new channel, Funny GSC 2.0. You're the realest MVP, man. At least now we are 30 subscribers.
We are?
Yeah, we are 30 subscribers. That's really good. At least we want to get to like 100 subscribers, guys. I know we can get there within 2 days. Yeah.
Plus, we have a special video for you guys.
Yes, we have a lot of special videos. Do you want to tell them?
No.
All right. We have a special video for you guys. But for this channel right here, we're going to do a lot of reactions. And also, we're not forgetting the people on this channel, man. You've been so kind and you've been so good. You are the realest MVP, man. Thank you so much. You're family now. So now, the thing is, today we're going to react to a video that was suggested by a lot of people. And they suggested that we should go react to Ahmed Dedat, pastor caught unaware of word-for-word copying in the Bible. Let's see what actually happened. So, without any further ado.
So, which one is the title? Is it that or this that we're looking
at? I don't know. Okay, here, what we're looking at says Ahmed Dedat debate with Pastor Stanley Joburg. Is the Bible truly the Word of God?
Interesting.
Yeah, let's find out.
And this was what? 1991?
Yeah, this was 1991. Damn. Were you born?
I knew you'd go there.
Well, I was born. I was born. I was like 20 years old at this time.
You wish.
Anyway, guys, let's get it.
These kings that I have, kings.
Kings. Now, to show you that these twins are not really twins, these are not identical. There is some deception here. They are identical on the face of it. I don't know if whether the pastor would like to cooperate. I would like him to open, if he pleases, if he will help me. Otherwise, I have to call somebody from the audience. If you will help me, this book here, Isaiah chapter 37. If you'll only open Isaiah 37. No, this one here. These are twins. We want to compare the twins to see how they are deceiving the Christian world, how they produce this by the millions and deceive the ordinary people. I just want to demonstrate that, and I would like him to help me with this one, sir. This is the Holy Bible, Revised Standard Version. Just open Isaiah 37, and I'll read from here and see whether it is the same. That's all. If you will, sir.
Shall I?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Just open it. Just open it. Just have a look, sir, while I'm reading. Just have a look whether I'm reading correctly. Isaiah 37.
Which verse?
From verse 1, sir. So we don't have to search. 37. Isaiah. Got it, sir? Verse 1. When King Hezekiah heard it, he rent his clothes and covered himself with sackcloth and went into the house of the Lord. Correct, sir?
Yes, I'm following.
Yes. And went into the house of the Lord, and he sent Eliakim, who was over the household, and Shebna the secretary, and the senior priest covered with sackcloth to the prophet Isaiah the son of Amos. Verse 3. They said to him, "Thus says Hezekiah, this day is a day of distress, of rebuke, and of disgrace. Children have come to the birth, and there is no strength to bring them forth. It may be that the Lord your God heard all the words of the Rabbi whom his master, the king of Assyria, has sent to mock the living God. And go on to verse 8, the Rabshakeh returned and found the king of Assyria fighting. And going on to verse 14, Hezekiah received a letter from the hand of the messengers and read it, and Hezekiah, and on, word for word the same.
Yes.
But sir, I'm not reading from the book of Isaiah, I'm reading from the book of Kings.
You'll explain that. It's the greatness of the Bible.
You see, word for word, I am reading 2 Kings 19, and he's confirming in Isaiah 37. In other words, word for word, it is the same. And let me share with you the knowledge I have gathered from the Christian learned men. They tell me, unless the pastor says to the contrary, that the Bible was not a verbal revelation. Like we Muslims believe about the Quran. We believe that the Quran was a verbal revelation. God Almighty tells his messenger, Qul huwallahu ahad. Say, he is God the one and only. So Muhammad says, Qul huwallahu ahad. So Allahu Samad, God the Eternal Absolute, so he says Allahu Samad. He says Lam Yalid wa Lam Yulad. He does not beget and is not begotten. So he says Lam Yalid wa Lam. It was the Quran is a verbal revelation. The Christians do not believe in a verbal revelation. They believe that the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, inspired people, tickled people to write. What do we wrote? But in that case, you can't have word for word reproduction. If somebody tickles you to write about this meeting, you can't reproduce word for word what the other man has written, the other journalist. Your wordings will differ, your settings will differ. This is human, even if you are inspired to write about this meeting. No two will be identical. Here, identical, which means that this was stolen. In literature, they call it plagiarism. Somebody has been plagiarizing what was written, this guy here, under his own name, he rewrites this whole thing and he says, this is mine. In literature, you call that stealing, and you can be charged for stealing. Now, God doesn't do that. He doesn't dictate to one prophet, and then he forgets what he has inspired, and he takes the trouble of repeating word for word, phrase for phrase, comma for comma, full stop for full stop. God doesn't do that, and the Holy Spirit don't do that. The professor, the pastor, will explain how it comes about that there is an identical word-for-word reproduction from one book written hundreds of years before the other book was written. How did they do that?
And it's very true that we do not believe in a verbal dictation. We believe in a complete, total inspiration. God is so great, he did not need to talk through the ears. He could talk directly into the hearts of the people.
What do you think about this video right here?
It's interesting. I'm just, so what exactly does this mean? I still can't wrap my thoughts around whatever the message was saying. What do you think it means?
I think Zip Ahmed Dadat was trying to prove that the Bible was plagiarized. Get it? Like the Christians, they believe that the people who wrote the Bible,
it's the people that wrote the Bible,
the people who wrote the Bible were inspired by God. but the Muslims, it's verbally, like God, you know.
It's a lot to take in.
I mean, it's a lot to take in, but isn't it that the stories in the Bible are just the same as stories in the Quran? Some of the stories.
There's that factor, but then, so other than plagiarism, so what else is it supposed to tell us?
Because according to, I was doing a research a while ago, and they were saying the Bible is the book of life and death, and it was taken from the ancient texts. So it's like plagiarism, like they took first, and the stories that are being told in the Bible, most of them are fictional type of stories, but I really don't know about that.
So do you think there's nothing in the Quran that's repeated?
I've not gotten a chance to read the Quran, but according to what the guy was saying, Ahmed Dedat, it clearly tells that there's nothing that is repeated, because he was really confident enough to even mention the Bible. Because they would have, you know what's really amazing about this thing? Like, these people know our Bible very well.
It's not that they know it very well.
No, it's like,
for him, he studied these things. You know, you can't teach a class if you have no knowledge.
I think
what's supposed to be taught.
I think there's some level of ignorance at some point. Because, why is this guy well knowledgeable when it comes to,
because he wanted to learn, he's taken time to learn. Look, I think someone in the comments said he studied all these religions. He knows.
Don't everybody,
you can't sit
don't
down
everyone,
because there's someone out there watched his teachings or these videos, and they've gone out and preached whatever he was saying
Without even going to do further research. But is it this not a good way to try and go through each and every religion so that to be able to understand them? You know, I feel it's so nice that way.
That's what I'm saying. This should push someone to look into whatever they believe in.
Yeah. Pretty true, though. But this is really shocking, because the girl was reading from Kings and this is reading from Isaiah. Like, oh my God.
It was so unexpected, because I was thinking this would be a debate, another one of those debates.
I was thinking, like, two Bibles, like in James and whatever Bible, and then it was reading from Isaiah, and then also here reading from Isaiah. I was thinking probably it's two different type of things, but it's a different book. That was so epic, amazing. Anyway, guys, if you feel like your reaction to this video in a better way, just give us a thumbs up. And don't forget to go down in our comment section, tell us exactly what you feel about our reaction and what you feel about Ahmed Dedat. I mean, I didn't expect this, to be honest. I didn't expect it. This is such an amazing, it's so nice to learn and so nice to understand things. I didn't know about this, but now, okay,
because I didn't even think people in 1991 were woke.
Wow, yeah, sure. This was 1991. Damn, that was long. Anyway, guys, thank you so much. And the most important thing, guys, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. The more keep us subscribing, the more keep us the motivation to do a lot of videos and to give you a better content. And for those guys who've been subscribing to the channel, thank you so much. And if you're new to this channel, we are Finding Jesse, and we do all type of reaction videos. If you want us to do a funny reaction video, just let us know. If you want us to do any sort of reaction, just let us know in the comment section below, and we're gonna do it for you guys. And yeah, thank you so much, and make sure, guys, we want to get to 10,000 subscribers in 2 days, and I know we can get there, so make sure you hit that subscription button. And last but not the least, we're gonna see you in the next video, and peace out.